Hey guys, welcome to the Testing Academy. My name is Pramod, and in this video, we are going to discuss about how to explain the test automation framework to the interviewer, right? So, and in this video, I'm going to give you the two important frameworks. I'm basically going to explain you step by step and few of the concepts that I'm going to explain you in this mind map. All right, so let's get started. Alright guys, so the first important point whenever you are explaining any kind of test automation framework to your interviewer, right? So what you need to tell about these is that you need to make sure that you are telling these four points. The first important point is programming language and the second important point is what kind of type of framework, what are the different packages that is in are there in this test automation framework that you have created, and what kind of CI/CD basically you guys are using, right? I am going to explain you further, and we are also going to see two full written test automation framework in Java, which have a full web driver, TestNG, ReportNG, Hello Report integrated, right? Two different kind of framework which contains a full-fledged automation framework ready to plug in, means you can use them in any kind of, you can say, your application, right? I'm going to explain you step by step, right? Before that, you need to understand the few concepts, right? So first you need to tell them about the language that you are going to use. For example, if you are talking about Java, right, you need to tell them that we have written this automation framework in Java. It uses POI library to fetch the test data from Excel file, right? And basically it's for CI/CD, basically this one, let me put it here, we are using Git, right? So these are the two important points that you need to tell, right? After that, what you need to do is that you need to tell them that the framework that you are going to is based on like data driven, right? And this data driven, basically what you mean by is that we are basically using test data from JSON, and if we are using from Excel, we need to mention that. If you are using any kind of MySQL DB, then we need to mention that also, right? And also in the framework, you can tell about that we are basically leveraging the page object model with Page Factory, right? And so these things you can mention whenever you're talking about this, your framework, right? Now, the most important point part, and most of the time you have to basically concentrate here, that what are the different packages that you have, right? So packages are nothing but the folder structure of your test automation framework that you have written, right? So the first one is utils. Basically, what kind of utils that you have? Let me do this thing. Yeah. So in the utils, you can mention that we are using certain libraries, which basically we have already written certain wrappers around how to read a file. Any kind of file, for example, text file or JSON file that you can do. We have written certain custom JSON parser, if it is, and we have written certain dynamic wrappers or dynamic element custom functions. If you have implemented it, all right, you can mention them. Now you can mention that we have certain custom listeners as well as certain another kind of listener, especially related to ReportNG if we have used, all right, and also we have implemented certain listeners which are basically going to use we are using them to basically capture the any kind of failure, right? So in the resource section, you can say that okay, we have certain fail screenshot configuration files, right? Similarly, these resources, like we have a separate configuration for staging environment and production environment, these things you can talk about. For report, we are using a ReportNG or an Hello Report or any kind of default, you can say TestNG, you can mention that also while talking about it, right? And in the TestNG file, why you are using, you can tell them that we are using for parallel execution, we are grouping our test cases for staging environment 1, staging environment 2, production, means we have grouped for regression set, smoke test, right? So we have grouped our test cases using this TestNG grouping mechanism, and we are using both of type of assertions, like soft assertion and hard assertions, right? Similarly, you can explain about the POM file that we have a different kind of profiles. For example, if you want to run all the tests on Firefox, Chrome, Opera, you can do that by using using the options of Maven by passing certain parameters, right? So that's pretty much about it. Like, it's a theoretical concept, I know. And in CI/CD, you can mention that we are using Jenkins, text execution status. We are basically emailing all the things, screenshots, flaky tests, right? So now what we do, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to explain you two of these frameworks, right? So this is one of the frameworks that I have basically got from internet, and it's one of the great, I believe it's one of the great, you can say, test automation framework already created, right? So what it is created in Java. So what we have is that we have it is written. So the main file is the POM file, which is basically a Maven file which contains all the dependencies. So we are using lots of dependency related to it. For example, we are using Selenium, we are using certain mail APIs, we are using MySQL connectors, we are using POI library for working with Excel files, right? And we are using TestNG, right? Similarly, we are also using ReportNG in this case, right? And so the structure remains very similar. So we have this Maven project. Maven projects most of the time contains main and test, right? Everything we should have on test, right? So in test Java, and right, in test case, we have base class, right? And which is going to, and we have login test, which is going to be used, going to use this base class, right? And we in the resources, especially in resources, we have lots of packages, like we have integrated, basically added all the drivers in this folder. We have added a certain configuration related to reports. We have grid configurations also here. Return, we have logs, we have certain property files which basically contains object repository, log4j files, as well as the configuration file, right? Similarly, we have certain runners, like TestNG runner we have. So we are going to run this login test and validate test, test number 2, test number 3, and we have a custom listener which basically you're going to use to create it's an event listener, right? And similarly, we have test data from two different kind of Excel files, right? So this is one of the framework that you can explain. So what you need to explain them is in a simpler manner is these page object model resources packages that you have, especially, and how you are running this test. For example, we are using Maven project. So Maven minus P, and we are basically mentioning all the things, right? Another interesting framework that I have come across is this one, which is basically a WebDriver TestNG Arch type, right? It's a Maven project, and if you need to run any this project especially, so what you need to do is that you need to pass Maven minus P. If you want to run for Chrome, you can pass a localhost, no grid test, or if you have already running your grid somewhere, or you are running a grid, you can mention that in POM file, right? Okay, so this is, again, it's a very big project containing dependency of TestNG, Selenium WebFactory, Selenium Java, and we have ReportNG also. And similarly, they have build configurations, right? This is another important point. And here also they have certain profiles related to it. For example, if you are loading a profile of Firefox, it's gonna load this file, all the configuration from files, Firefox capabilities. If you're loading Chrome, you can load this file. Similarly, for different browsers, they have different files loading from capabilities, right? Similarly, we have certain parameters like related to profiles for localhost, dev host, kind of environment of staging 1, staging 2, and production, right, thing. Similarly, we have grid URL also mentioned that right now it is localhost. You can have any kind of grid running on, you can mention here, right? So the folder structure remains the same. Again, we have two main and test Maven projects, right? In main, we don't have anything. In most of the things are related are in test. So in resources, we have TestNG file, which contains a simple test and basically two listeners for ReportNG, right? And here in the resource section, we have certain browser capabilities, which are basically right now only telling about the Chrome browser, but you can have mentioned, right, any kind of Chrome, what is the version of it, what are the OS it is, means you can have this capability here, right? Similarly, we have certain listeners. Right now, we don't have any kind of listener, custom listener, but you can have a certain custom listener for your reporting mechanism, right? Similarly, in Java folder, we have certain like pages. This is a parent page, and this is the page basically which is extending, and this is a page object model, right? and we have certain suite configurations. Basically, this configuration are going to load all the configuration from your capability files, right? Similarly, we have test case file. This is the simplest test case file, which is basically going to first initialize the home page using page factory mechanism, and after that we are executing our test cases, right, in this one. So this is in a simpler manner, what you can do is that you can, if you have a telephonic interview, right, you can go through them, the folder structure, your project about it, how you're testing it. And if you have, means if you are doing it personally, you can draw the diagram, right? So what you can do, similarly, you can explain them about this poem, right? Let me pull up this. You can explain about the poem, different profiles, different dependency that you have on poem file. You can tell them how you're using TestNG file to run your test cases, right? Similarly, what kind of listeners you are using, how this page object model is working, right? You can explain all about the poem, right, here. Similarly, you can mention about the utilities that you are using, any kind of utility that you have written, for example, fetching the test data from Excel file, writing data set somewhere, any kind of log4j logs mechanism that you have used, right? So you can mention that also here, all right? So this is another, and if we talk about for this one, similarly, you can mention about the poem, and you can mention about lots of different test resources that you are basically going to leverage, right? Similarly, the poem structure that you can tell about and the reports that you have generated, right? So this is how basically you are, let me go back. So this is one of the simplest way to tell, explain any kind of test automation framework that you have written in Java to your interviewer, right? I hope you have gained lots of knowledge in this one, and especially if you are going to explain next time, just explain them what exactly we have discussed here. And if you have any question, let me know in the comments. I will be happy to help. And don't forget to share and like this video, and see you in the next video. This is your host Prambodh. Bye.